وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى in today's episode I want to carry on speaking about المحاسبة للنفس, accounting yourself, looking and pondering over and contemplating on what you say and what you do. From the ways, inshallah ta'ala, that you could do muhasabatu nafs, it's for the person to look at their own actions, in which you do daily, and those which you have to do at night. You think about them. And you ask yourself this question, وَهَلْ هَذِهِ الْأَعْمَالِ يَسَّرَهُ أَنْ يَلْقَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِهَا أَمْ لَا. Yani you ask yourself this question. These actions that you're doing, هل هذه الأعمال, these actions that you're doing, يسره أن يلقى الله سبحانه وتعالى بها أم لا? Is it something that you know that it will please Allah when you meet him يوم القيامة? That's a question you need to ask yourself. So for example, you look at your actions starting from the obligatory acts, the واجبات, the things which are obligatory. Once you've looked at that, if that's intact, when it's good, then you move on to فيما يتعلق بالمنهيات, the things that are prohibited, the things Allah تبارك وتعالى He prohibited سبحانه وتعالى upon His slaves. And then the person, after looking at the prohibited, you move on to the third, which is الرغائب والمستحبات. You look at the recommended acts of worship. Okay, where are you in regards to that? Are you fasting Mondays and Thursdays? Are you praying voluntary prayers? Okay, that's called al-muhasabatu bid-daraja. You are pondering and you're thinking and you're contemplating based on levels. So you're starting from the wajibat. Am I doing the wajibat? Yes, alhamdulillah, that's good. Now that you say, second thing that you say is, am I staying away from the prohibited acts or speeches? Am I staying away from it? If you say yes to that, then your third question you ask yourself is, what about the al-raghaib? والمستحبات, the recommended acts. What about those? Where are you in regards to that? Once you do that, you're inshallah ta'ala upon a path which is يعني, good, and you're heading towards the right direction. Okay? The obligatory acts are a lot. And when you look at the obligatory acts, you first of all look at your salah that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made obligatory on you. Are you doing the salahs that you're praying? This is muhasaba. Do I pray my salah بشروطها, with its conditions? Am I praying the salah with its arkan, the pillars that are in the prayer that I need to come with? Am I coming with it? And then you say, the salah that I pray, am I doing the wajibat? You ask yourself, the salah that I'm praying, am I doing it في أوقاتها, in its timing? And also you ask yourself, these salahs that I'm praying, am I doing it مع جماعة المسلمين? Am I doing it with the Muslims? يعني, Al-Imam Ibn Al-Qayyim said something very powerful regarding the salah. And the person needs to really internalize what he said, rahimahullah, in his kitab, Asraru As-Salah. Ibn Al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, he said, لا ريب أن الصلاة قرة عيون المحبين ولذة أرواح الموحدين وبستان العابدين ولذة نفوس الخاشعين وبحق أحوال الصادقين وميزان أحوال السالكين وهي رحمة الله المهداة إلى عباده المؤمنين. That's what the salah is to the believers. It is what brings warmth to their eyes. It's قرة عيون المحبين. Those who love the prayer, when they pray, they find warmth and comfort and tranquility and ease. ولذة أرواح الموحدين. It's the sweetness of the spirits and the soul of the ones who only worship Allah تبارك وتعالى. It is the bustanul abidin. It's the garden of the worshippers. وَلَذَّةُ نُفُوسِ الْخَاشِعِينَ. It's the sweetness of the humble creations of Allah تبارك وتعالى. وَمَحَقُّ أَحْوَالِ الصَّادِقِينَ. It's the crux of the situation of the truthful slaves of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. It is also وَمِيزَانُ أَحْوَالِ السَّالِكِينَ. Those who are treading the path to get to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, that's their scaling. That's what everything is based on for them.
وَهِيَ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ الْمُهْدَاتِ. It is a mercy sent from Allah to guide us. إِلَىٰ عِبَادِهِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. To His slaves.
Allah is doing it for them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, I haven't first of all given justice to the statement of Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah. It's so eloquent, rahimahakikatan. But you've understood the gist.
So when you are pondering and you're contemplating, first thing you start off is with the prayer. After la ilaha illallah, you come with to the prayer. ولذلك الشيخ عبد الرزاق ابن عبد المحسن العباد has a very good book. It's called تعظيم الصلاة. It's worth reading. Get that kitab and look into it. I've heard, والله أعلى وأعلم, I've heard that it is translated. So inshallah ta'ala, look at that kitab. It's a kitab ماتع, and it is a مصنف نافع that Sheikh عبد الرزاق ابن عبد المحسن العباد wrote called تعظيم الصلاة. It's worth reading inshallah ta'ala. After the person looks at the salah and they ponder over the salah, then the person looks at the other wajibat of the religion. Okay? And the person also looks at the things Allah prohibited subhanahu wa ta'ala from his slaves. Have you really stayed away from those things? Drinking alcohol, committing zina, and etc. Are you staying away from those things Allah has prohibited subhanahu wa ta'ala? Also, you look at the precision of your actions. Yani, how precise are you in whatever you do in the religion? Is it precise? Am I doing it with precision? Am I giving it the best that I could give? Wallahi, once you do that, and you then thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep you firm upon that, what you're going to find is a lot of good. And then you repent to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for any deficiencies that have passed that you've come with, and any deficiency that you currently are coming with, because this world again that we're living in, brothers and sisters, is darul amal. It's the place of actions. This is the chance that we have. We all know the famous hadith al-Qudsi where Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, He says, Ya ibadi, innama hiya a'malukum uhsiha lakum thumma uwafikum iyaha faman wajada khayran falyahmadillah. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَهُ. It's everyone's actions today. How precise are you in your actions? How much effort and hard work are you putting in? Are you holding back? The matter is, يَا عِبَادِي إِنَّمَا هِيَ أَعْمَالُكُمْ. It's everyone's actions, أُحْصِيهَا لَكُمْ, that is being accounted for them. فَمَنْ وَجَدَ خَيْرًا فَلِيَحْمَدِ اللَّهِ. If you find good in it, praise Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ وَجَدَ غَيْرَ ذَلِكَ. And if you find anything other than that, فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَكَ. Don't blame anyone except yourself. فَلَا يَلُومَنَّ إِلَّا نَفْسَكَ. The person should not blame anyone except himself. We need to repent all the time, brothers and sisters. And by repenting, you have to have come with حَاسِبُ أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُ. You had to have come with the concept of الْمُحَاسَبَةُ للنفس. To say that I did a sin, oh Allah, اغفر لي, forgive me, oh Allah. Tawbah comes from recognition of your mistakes and what you've done. Okay? If you look at the righteous people, the great Imams of Al-Islam, the people who, inshallah ta'ala, we want to tread on their path, Salafun al-Salih, our pious predecessors, starting from our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to repent, rectify their situation, and they used to always want to work hard. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, a person who is forgiven for everything, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as Allah mentions to us in the Quran, inna fatahna laka fatahan mubeena liyaghfira laka Allahu ma taqaddama min dhanbika wa ma ta'akhkhar. Layla Muhammad, yani, he is errorless in the sense where Allah tabaarak wa ta'ala, everything is forgiven for, alayhi salatu wasalam. Ma'a dhalika, he told us salawatullahi wasalamu alayhi, he said, inni atubu fil yawmi mi'ata marrah. I repent to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala every day 100 times. And Allah accepts the repentance, He told us, alayhi salatu wasalam, from every person who does a mistake and does a shortcoming, or comes with a shortcoming, Allah will accept that repentance and that rectification from you.
Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and his father, on the يعني, in Jami' al-Tirmidhi and Ibn Majah and Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah graded it to be sahih, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ تَوْبَةَ الْعَبْدِ مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرْ. Allah, he accepts subhanahu wa ta'ala the repentance from the slave as long as he doesn't what? مَا لَمْ يُغَرْغِرْ. As long as the moment of death doesn't come to him. Okay, before you pass away. Also, Imam Muslim narrated on the authority of Abu Musa radiallahu ta'ala anhu that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزَّ وَجَلَ يَبَسُطُ يَدَهُ بِاللَّيْلِ لِيَتُوبَ مَسِيءُ النَّهَارِ وَيَبَسُطُ يَدَهُ بِالنَّهَارِ لِيَتُوبَ مَسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسُ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he opens his palm بِاللَّيْلِ at night time to accept the repentance of the people who've asked Allah forgiveness for that day. And he also opens his palm subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the repentance of the one. So he does it daytime and he does it nighttime. He does it nighttime for the ones who ask repentance for the whole day. And the same is, وَيَبْسُطُ يَدَهُ, Allah opens his palm, بِالنَّهَارِ daytime, لِيَتُوبَ, so he can forgive, مُسِيءُ اللَّيْلِ, the one who, يعني, committed mistakes and shortcomings at nighttime. He does all of this, حَتَّى تَطْلُعَ الشَّمْسُ مِنْ مَغْرِبِهَا, until the sun comes from the opposite direction. So that's consistent repentance. That's how the Salaf al-Salih, including the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahabas were like. And يعني, in more than one of the great Imams of Al-Islam also, in their biography you find that they were hardworking. That if it was said to them, إِنَّ مَلَكَ الْمَوْتِ بِبَابِكِ, that the angel of death is standing at the door. And he's standing there, لِقَبْضِ رُوحِكَ, to take your soul. He would not be able to. يعني, لم يكن عنده مزيد عمل. He wouldn't have anything more to do. Why? لأنه في كل الأمور منتظم. Because everything is on schedule. He's a يعني في المحافظة عليها وأدائها. Everything is doing it accordingly. But there's some people, brothers and sisters, from the people. If today it was said to them that the angel of death is standing at the door and he's going to take your soul, he will find in front of himself, يجد أمامه أمورا كثيرة. He will find many things in front of himself, many things. يعني, what shall I start? Where shall I start from? What can I do? Where? Which one? There's so many wajibat that we've left behind. There's so many muharramat that we've fallen into. So we're muqassir in everything. So which one should we start with? And we don't want to be like those people, brothers and sisters, who will come يوم القيامة and they will say, لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت. كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها ومن وراء برزخ إلى يوم يبعثون. We don't want to be like that, brothers and sisters. That's not our aim and our objective. It was mentioned, and Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله يسير على من نبلاء, he brings many examples of great imams who were like that. Bukayr ibn Amir, it was said, كان لو قيل, Bukayr ibn Amir رحمه الله, he mentions, if it was said to عبد الرحمن ibn Abi Nu'min, if it was said to him, قد توجه إليك ملك الموت, the angel of death has come to your direction. ما كان عنده زيادة عمل. He did not have anything more to add to it. وكان يمكث جمعتين لا يأكل. He will stay for two jum'as not eating. Anas ibn Iyad, he said, رأيت صفوان ibn سليم. I saw صفوان ibn سليم. I saw him. ولو قيل له, if it was said to him, غدا القيامة, the tomorrow is يوم القيامة, ما كان عنده مزيد على ما هو عليه من العبادة. He did not have anything more to add on the actual ibadah he was doing. It was also mentioned that Hushaym rahimahullah, he said, كان منصور ابن يعني زاب, he said, كان منصور ابن زادان, Hushaym is saying this, if it was said to him, إن ملك الموت, the angel of death, على الباب, is standing in front of the door, ما كان عنده زيادة في العمل. There's nothing more he could possibly do. Allahu Akbar. Imagine that, brothers and sisters, how hard you have to be working for you to be told Qiyamah is tomorrow, or the angel of death is right now at the front door. He's going to take your nafs. Like, think about it. How hard do you have to really work for you not to have anything more to do? And it shows that they were consistently in ibadah in everything that they did. And the reason why they got that, brothers and sisters, is they were known for being ones who came with يعني محاسبة للنفس. They accounted themselves for everything they did. Okay? And they looked at their actions day and night. What am I doing? What am I not doing? Brothers and sisters, we will not be in any way, shape or form to achieve all of that unless Allah helps us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's a common mistake that many people fall into. And it's a common mistake which a lot of us fall into. And I myself have also, يعني, I'm guilty of as well. Which is, we spread this concept and we say it a lot to people. We say to people, have a thiqatu bin nafs. I've used that quite a lot. We say that to the people. We say to them, go and have thiqa in yourself. يعني, rely on yourself. And that's something we shouldn't say to the people. That's wrong. It goes against an important point in our religion. A thiqatu bin nafs. Thiqa, brothers and sisters, is tawakkul. And يعني, it's not just tawakkul. Thiqa is not just tawakkul. It's actually khulasatu tawakkul wa lubbu. It's the core of tawakkul. Thiqa is the core of tawakkul. Okay? And we will know the famous dua that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to do, which is Allahumma rahmataka arjuk. يعني, sorry. He used to say Allahumma rahmataka arju fala takilni ila nafsi tarfata aynin wa aslih li sha'ni kullah. La ilaha illa ant. This, brothers and sisters, in this dua, the Prophet would say, oh Allah, rahmataka arju, I hope for your mercy. فَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِي طَرْفَةَ عَيْنِي. Don't leave me to my own self. Where is the thiqa to be nafs? Where is a thiqa? Rely on yourself. That doesn't exist. We ask Allah, فَلَا تَكِلْنِي إِلَى نَفْسِي. Oh Allah, do not let me يعني, run my own affairs. I can't do it. I need you, Ya Rabbi Al-Alamin. So when you say to the person, have thiqa to be nafs, and thiqa is tawakkul, and tawakkul should be done for who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ولذلك the mufti, before Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Ibrahim al-Shaykh, he was asked about the statement that the people say to one another, تجب الثقة بالنفس. You have to have thiqa in yourself. He said, لا تجب ولا تجوز. He said, it's not wajib, and rather it's not even allowed. الثقة بالنفس. And then he mentioned the hadith, فلا تكلني إلى نفسي طرفة عين. You can find that in his فتاوى ورسائل, رحمه الله. Also, Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, رحمه الله, he has a kitab called Mu'jam Al-Manahi Al-Lafziyya. Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, rahimahullah, in there he talks about, Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, in there, he speaks about terms that people use which are prohibited in the Sharia. He talks about names and terms and things like that. It's worthy of reading. And he says that in page 185. Every action that you do, brothers and sisters, when it comes to the topic that I'm speaking about, حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. Every action that you do, brothers, and you come with, make sure that you come with it with the two pillars. What are the two pillars? With sincerity, do it for Allah's sake, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and do it in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Al-Alama Hafiz al-Hakami, he said, بِالشَّرْعِ زِنْ كُلَّ الْأَمْرِ مَا هَمَمْتَ وَبِهِ فَإِنْ بَدَى صَالِحًا أَقْدِمْ وَلَا تَجِمِ. Every action that you want to do, يعني بالشرع زين. Scale it in the Sharia. Is this in line with the Sharia? يعني بالشرع زين كل أمر ما هممت. Everything you intend to do, weigh it in the religion. به فإن بدا صالحا. And then if it seems to be good, then أقدم ولا تجني. يعني go forward and do it. Do it with sincerity, brothers and sisters. And do it in accordance to the way that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did it. The way he sanctioned, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala every day of your life that Allah gives you thabat. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in this little reminder that I gave, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ ذِكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. The benefit, you see, it benefits the believer. And inshallah ta'ala, I hope it has benefited you all. أسأل الله عز وجل أن يصلح لنا أجمعين ديننا الذي هو عصمة أمرنا وأن يصلح لنا دنيانا التي فيها معاشنا وأن يصلح لنا آخرتنا التي فيها معادنا وأن يجعل الحياة خير زيادة لنا في كل خير وأن يجعل الموت راحة لنا في كل شر. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنه تبارك وتعالى سميع قريب مجيب والله تعالى أعلم. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله استغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.